Hello, welcome to UFO Afterlight. This is the second trilogy in the Xcom series. The first trilogy was Xcom, the original game. Then after it came Xcom Terror from the Deep, which in my opinion was the better version because you had this big, beautiful planetary chess battle, which you had so much fun. I mean, you used to research technologies and learn about what the aliens wanted, what their bases meant, what their ships meant, what their ship purpose was, because they had a lot. I mean, if you see someone complain about the ship combat, or not ship combat, aircraft combat, or the intercept game, you'll soon find out that that game was such a big part of the XCOM series. I mean, it's a shame they took it out and forced you to play almost a subpar strategy, in my opinion. And then you had the second trilogy. Sounds like Star Wars, right? You had UFO Aftermath, and then you have UFO Aftershock and UFO Afterlight. So in UFO Aftermath, the humans lost the war. The planet was almost conquered by the Reticulans, the little grey aliens. And then you had to fight for the planet because they wanted to terraform our planet, which was very dangerous, because by terraforming the planet it would have become a supercomputer, a living supercomputer, and that would have been very bad for the humans. And in Aftershock you also control a Laputa, which is a giant spaceship, and you can also build ground bases, and the bases have to be connected with one another, and you can collect resources to strengthen your army, your bases, and could also recruit cyborg and hackers. Again, short story, long story. There was also a human cult that worshipped the Reticulans, and some other aliens get involved as well. Okay, let's get to this game. So this is the most polished game, the most beautiful game. I mean, the graphics are a bit more cartoonish than you want, especially because in the other two games the weapons were realistic. Well, almost all of them were realistic. But in this one, they took a more cartoonish approach because they wanted to spend more time on the strategy part of the game. Yeah, I'm talking too much, I know. I'll start the game right now. But in this game, they improved a lot the planet combat, meaning you all have to play the planetary chess battle again. And this time it's better than ever because you also have diplomacy, more races to fight, or to actually can join them. You can make an alliance and fight some common threats together. But at the same time, humans were evicted from the Earth, the ones that accepted. The Laputa is still on Earth with survivors, but the aliens, well, the peace treaty forced a lot of humans to move to Mars, and they are stuck in cryogenic sleep, and the Reticulans gave them a lot of, well, resources and support and technology, but at the same time they didn't give them the most important ones. So you have to terraform Mars, so the humans that can live here. You have 10,000 people sleeping here. That was a long intro. But again, the stories of these games are just fascinating to me, because XCOM is one of the first games I ever played. You'll have to adjust your playstyle a lot to this game, and you'll have to tinker with it a lot until you find your settings and your everything you wanted. Okay, let's start the game because it's a strategic and tactical game. Oh, excuse me. Is that better for you? Thank you. This game has so much depth to it, so much strategy, so much thinking part, so much RPG to it that you wouldn't believe it.
On my way.
This is actually not a tutorial, but also... Hey, come back. But also the start of the game, meaning this is the campaign. I miss games that did this. I mean, you started the campaign by doing a little game, a little tutorial.
Relocating.
So you are a construction site right here, and you find someone dead.
I'll do my best.
And some strange mech warrior or something like that, alien anyway.
What's next, sir? I'm ready.
You pick up that gun. Well, if you had used the tutorials, that'd be very handheld, and I don't like handhelding.
Targeting.
As you can see, you can't even see his name. I think that's a graphical error, because that's mech.
Targeting. One less.
There, go. Let's go here.
Waiting for orders.
Okay, now we can do this. Also, see how many options you have here. She can stand, run, attack location, walk mode, stand mode. So many options.
Next,
and the map is a little outdated now, but it still serves well. I mean, look at this. This is just fascinating in my opinion. Because it looks and feels like Mars. And your goal here is to terraform the whole planet, but you'll soon find out your neighbors have different plans. Now let's see how the game behaves when you control more people. And just listen to that voice confirmation. This is almost like Age of Empires, like a strategy game. Okay, you also have the leveled system, the multiple levels of the environment.
Someone's there. On my way.
Okay, a little drone.
Engaging.
No way, sir.
I'm ready. I'm afraid I can't do that.
Okay, you also can do friendly fire in the game. If you do that, see? Oh,
what's next?
There's something wrong with the game. I'll fix it next time, I promise. Maybe if I ever do another episode of this game.
Your orders? I got him. Relocated.
You got him, right. Now, this being another game, sometimes you have to tinker with it a lot. Okay. Look at all these options, believe me. Strategic and tactical game. They really wanted to make the game even more friendly to use. But at the same time, well, they managed to make it harder on newer people. This is your ship.
What to do now? Our archaeologists have been attacked by some mechanical drones on the excavation site at Cydonia. Seems like the ancient Martians have not left their dwellings unprotected.
We will have to learn how to use weapons, and a few of us will have to become soldiers, so we can accompany the scientists. Fortunately, the Reticulans gave us their laser weapons. Unfortunately, the batteries for them are scarce as hell. Can we produce some more?
I'm afraid we are not familiar with this technology.
In that case, we can postpone our research of Mars terraformation and concentrate on laser technologies. On the other hand, it might be easier to browse the database brought from Earth and start production of projectile firearms.
Some of the oldest settlers still keep their guns for mutant wars on Earth. They will surely lend them to our scientists for study.
As soon as we get the blueprints, we'll create a production line and start weapons production.
So, I really like that chat. I mean, they'll do this a lot of times during the game. They'll just let you know certain things there, and it feels you, I don't know, it feels like you're watching a story. I mean, think of it this way. They're practically playing the game for you. You're just telling them what to do, like almost like a sim. That's so great. That's so... Also, you have a lot of overviews and storage and... Oh, come on. You don't even want to know how much options you have in this game. So let's go to the base. And this is where all the peoples are. Cryogenic monument, mausoleum. I mean, this is really forces you to respect the gameplay and the story. Aqueduct ending. This is where you received your water. Check that out. Well, it cuts out there, but you can see. Okay, these are the pods, I don't know how to call them, the domes in which you build them, and you see how much space you have left to build, a lot of space to build. Civil engineering, technical bay. Okay, so let's start with the... I don't know even how to start it. Okay, let's go and see what we have here. So, you have a squad. This is your first squad. Actually, let's do it like this. This is the equipment tab. And let's see what weapons they have. I really need to fix this somehow, but again, this is some kind of error that I can probably solve by looking at something else and switching something around. And you also have the alien weapons right here. So she can hit pretty good. She's pretty good at aiming, good, average, good. So, I will give him the Actually, no. I remember she was our... She was our main lady. And Samantha too. And also, look at their name. They are different names. They are from different countries, different nationalities. The attention to details is amazing in this game. Actually, and he will be a better shooter. Okay, how about now? And I don't think he can dual wield as much as I wanted, but we'll try it. That's about it. You don't need any health kits for now, any other nonsense for now. The production tab. Also, research tab is your most important. And you can really choose what to research here. You're not limited by anything. Thank you. So you can just go into basic combat weapons and train all these things, or you can do the terraforming planetology. Also, everyone here has to learn and they'll get experience. So if they research a lot, they can increase their skills. So for example, to be better researching Earth technology. That will make this technology easier to research. This will go from difficult to hard or something like that, or to simple, depending on, again, a lot of factors. So I'll go with survival methods because I want to get a suit first. Well, actually, I'll go with the firearms. Actually, I'll go with both since you can queue them up. We'll have unavailable and completed. Production tab. This will get a lot more complicated when you get into it. Okay, let's have free I always make some dynamite, and this is a multi-tool, and you can, these are repair cartridges or something, let's just call it that. Also, you'll have two teams on the planet, meaning these are the scientists, these are the combat team, these are the engineer team, and this is the science vessel. And you have the technical bay as well. Oh, so many things to do and to choose. So, you can take them out of their ships, out of their tasks, and reassign them. And what I like to do is usually do this, assign another one to the team, and also this big, strong guy. Okay, because you also want to make a larger squad, because you also need some equipment to the team as well. These guys are pure soldiers in that way, so you'll need a scientist to act as a doctor and an engineer to act as an engineer. And the further you get into the game, more people will wake up. Or if you lose someone, they die permanently, but another one will be waken up, meaning the base cannot support everyone right now. But they can wake someone up if someone dies every start. I mean, look, the story is perfect. The setting is perfect. I don't know what more could you want. So, you'll get more people in the future once you develop your base. But if someone dies, they will wake someone up. Because for now, this is all they can afford and all they can do. There is no problem if you take someone out. But you can get him some driving skills and her some better building skills and so on. Wow, that's a very long intro. And also, you don't want to leave them without any weapons. You can give them the buzzsaw. But sooner or later you'll have to give them weapons, and besides, you have a big team, you may think. But check this out. You have 6 people, but sometimes 2 people can be hurt. One people can be training, and someone, well, you know, you're putting him on engineering duty, so you can build something faster. So you can be left only with a team of 3 people. And again, the game can get very rough, depending on your choices and how your loadout is, and... I'm talking too much. Okay, the research is on, everything is doing fine. Okay, we like the fuel, because we need a fuel line. And this one has a... Come on, where can I go? Here. Please go there. So, you can build mines right here with a technical scientific craft. Actually, build the geological probes first, which claim you the territory, and then with the technical craft, you build the mines.
A new item has been produced.
I won't go into much detail because, again, this is a very complicated game, but complicated in a good way, meaning you also have a lot of tutorials and menus and.
Has been built on the planet.
Thank you.
On exploring our new territory in the south, we ran into the reticulans that brought us here and assisted us in founding our Mars colony.
Well, that's interesting. Go on.
They suggest cooperation. They offer their weapons and scientific support.
And what do they ask for in exchange?
I bet that our enemies are hot on their heels as well.
They even offer to send some of their, well, men, if we need them. They have serious problems with attacking robots and are asking for our help.
Okay. This is the people left on Earth, meaning the Laputians, the Laputakru. And these are the reticulans. What they're offering? They're offering one fuel, the Alliance, the rocket launcher, a laser rifle and some batteries for their weapons. Let's accept, because this is story. Well, you can refuse, but the game will be a lot harder if you do that. Okay, let's build that fuel mine. So now the second craft will go out and build it. And you need a lot of fuel so you can cover most of the planet, but watch this. This is completely unexplored then.
A new item has been produced.
Okay, let's go to production. Also, you want to balance your game out, because if you don't research enough, or you research in a bad way, meaning you research only difficult things, well, that will make your game a lot harder than it should be. Because you can't really build everything you research, and some researchers are dead ends because they only lead to something else. And that can lead to something else, and can lead you with nothing to produce. Okay, let's make a few of these. And also a lot of fuel. You can use this for other laser weapons, other human laser weapons. That's a boss, so sorry about that. I should have fixed that before, but again, doesn't affect the game too much in my opinion. Because I can tell you everything you need to know.
A new station has been built on the planet.
And also you can play the game like this. That is researching. Great, that was occupied. Great. The research was completed.
Some of the scientists are unemployed. We could consider building a new lab.
Space suits and related technology. Let's see what we have here. Devices. Well, nothing yet. Sometimes you'll have to build them in the base. The Mars simulation.
Construct a new type of building.
And once again, you can build a lot of things, meaning you'll need some more hospital wings to heal them because they don't heal on their own. And also polytechnics, university, and so on. I can't even get into how complicated the game is, but you will see if you play it for yourself. This is mainly to convince you to try it. It's pretty cheap, I mean, you can get it at a sale. So everything seems in order now. You can also queue them up. Tabat, Klavlamo and Okla. Okay, this is something I have to show you. Okay. Drones, aliens. Okay, that's Tabita, and he's Okla or something. You also have their history. Ogi, he's called Ogi by the humans, and Tabby. Ogi and Tabby. So he's a soldier and he's a scientist. They can, when you level them up, they'll have specific skills for them. And some of them are pretty hilarious. Okay, her history. In Karl Marx Stadt, Chemnitz, Central Europe. Olympic Games in the former United States. Because she was a fierce warrior, she was exiled to Mars. Most experienced soldier. He has a daughter, Olga. Which I think is the next one, is they wake up. And again, minor surveyor. Oh, and that as well. Some of them have skills. Minor surveyor, meaning he's better at building. But again, I'm getting too many details. I'll just show the combat next.
A new attempt to contact the Council of the Earth as we ceased communication after our previous, well, misunderstanding. Anyway, the Laputa communication facility appears to be not functional, as we have not received any response. The emergency plan for this situation requires us to build a standby communication satellite.
It takes but a few days to build such a device. We just need to check a couple of technical details.
No trouble for my staff. Everything should be in the records brought from the Earth.
Again, the story will advance when you hit certain points in the game, or you just want to be.
Some of the scientists are unemployed.
You need Mars simulation to research this, and also the heavy suit, and also. Yeah, because it makes sense. This is not Earth. You need other types of armor and suits, because they just won't do it in this environment. Also, in the beginning.
A new item has been produced.
Something or somebody damaged the pipes, bringing water from the North Pole. I'm afraid that our reserves will not last for more than 3 days. We must repair them, or we are all going to die.
May it have a bearing on the latest events in some way?
We have discovered no seismic activity, meteor fall, or anything that might cause damage this large. Nothing like this has happened till now. Therefore, we are definitely bound to assume some relationship.
In this case, I suggest sending UFO and armored crew to the place. We can't risk losing our technical team or their vehicles. From now on, this planet seems not to be as safe as it used to be.
Somebody from the technical staff should come with the UFO to mend everything, at least a bit.
We have occupied new territory. Our water supply has been suspended. Our
territory
has been invaded.
A new station has been built on the planet. Input of resources has been decreased.
You can just make them in a queue and they'll build them all alone. But it's harder this way. And you have to fight for some territories. So what does this mean? So the environment hostility is won by day and two by night. If you go out, let's say out to this part of the map, like this one or this one, anyway, further from your base, you can have an hostility of, let's say, 5 in the day, 5 in the nighttime and 4 in the daytime. So you have to do the mission in the daytime. This is another level of strategy, because if you don't research and produce the suits fast enough, you can lose the game or a lot of important resources just by not being able to finish it, or defending your water supply. So again, it's very strategical. If you have a technician in this mission, they'll gain great experience. So some missions, if you have the technician or a scientist, they'll get a lot of experience. So let's do this first combat and see who's attacking our waterline. That graphic was pretty good, right? And I don't want to take our soldiers because they don't have weapons. Also, I could have given them the laser rifles, but I forgot. Anyway, that's not the important thing here.
What's next?
So, in most missions like this, you have to kill the enemy. And as I said before, friendly fire is in the game. Don't do it. Because puncturing your suit here will mean they have to repair the suit, and that's not always used to. Okay, get back.
I have visual. Ready? Kick ass.
Okay, we are being invaded here. Oh, such a shame that is not working properly. And also, you can do this.
Sure thing.
Fire a lot of bullets. Fast shot or aim shot?
Moving out now. There we go.
They shoot at me.
Okay. Those ones are not dead. That's temporary damage and they can heal some of it and get back up. But first we want to incapacitate them. Ooh, there's someone. Oh, okay, that's a lot of tough drones. Target eliminated. Also, you have to go by the sound cues.
Ready? I'll get him.
What's next?
Orders.
Engaging.
They're shooting.
Ready? Actually, let's have him on that one.
What to do now?
Aim burst. Okay, you go there. You go there and execute the remaining ones.
Orders? I'll get him.
Ready?
Your orders. Attacking.
Okay, that one got up. So you constantly have to check the targets of their targets. They also do EMP damage, which will stun your soldiers and do some permanent damage, which they have to stay in a hospital to get healed. Also, if they get closer, they have a better chance of hitting them. So that was the mission. We finished the mission. Basically, almost all the missions will be search and destroy the enemy. Some of them will be get an artifact back or destroy a building, but those are further into the game. The game does a very good job of helping you along the way. So, he killed a lot of things. He leveled up. Also, check out his technical and Psy experience. That's completely different, as I said. Can also get some corpses. Sometimes you'll have a full list here because the other races will have more loot. But this is not a race to get the most rare artifact. This is a race to improve your base and your technology in any way you see possible. Meaning you can use the reticulant technology, you can use the Martian technology, let's say like that, or the human technology. You have three choices from the beginning. Or you can just train them better and give them some laser rifles and conserve their ammo. That will also work. Again.
They expect more robot assaults at the aqueduct, this time farther from the base. But our fuel supply for UFO is not large enough to cover the whole length of the pipeline.
The fuel we mine comes from the field north of the base. I guess there should be a few more somewhere around.
My team may establish automatic geological sonds in the neighboring regions. If we discover a new field, technicians could start building a mine immediately.
If they do, they should prospect for metal deposits and other raw materials we may badly need in the near future as well.
Okay, so that's about it. I'll just explain some nice things, some nice details about the game. So the reticulants here hold the rare metals, which you can't advance to the next tech stage. I mean, the better weapons need those resources and also technology and some base buildings. And then the Martians will rise up all over your base, but that will be a long, it's a long time until you get there. Mainly the Beastmen, which will come a bit sooner than you may think, will attack your pipeline. For now, you have to find those Martian drones, but again, once they come, you'll have to fight again the planetary chess battle. That's just amazing. Now, let's check this out a bit. And if you had researched the military training first, now, you could have put them to train, and I think I should have done that first, because this is taking too long. And by now we should have trained our soldiers in some way, because the skills are very important in the game. The skills, not the attributes, because this can be excellent, legendary or something like that. And these ones will improve also. So, speed is good, and agility is good, but let's see. Skills like this one, more damage against reticulants and more likely to cause critical hits because she's a veteran. He has minor stability. He can get knocked down, because if you take a lot of fire, you'll get knocked down. Depending on which weapon you are shot with, you can get knocked down, and that's a big trouble, as you saw with some of those drones, because sometimes you lose HP and... I don't know, don't ever lose your firing line, because the enemies will always outnumber you. Okay, he has minor heavy equipment, rocket launchers. Well, she has no skill, but she's great. And you also have the storage and a lot of things you can...
Some of the weapons may be further refined.
You have statistics, you have compose, you even have accessories for the weapons, and then you can compose some great weapons and build them, like sniper rifles with certain muzzle attachments, barrel attachments. Again, this game is very complex, and if you install the mods, the game gets even better. So this is what I want from... Thank you. This is what I want from a new XCOM game. This. The base building, the interception game, the tactical game, the planetary, just this is what the XCOM is truly like, not just a whole string of battles which you have to complete in the most perfect way possible, or else you die. Well, you can really lose soldiers here, but as I said, sometimes it's hard to lose them, it depends on what missions you have, and you'll get so good at the game that some missions you'll realize are not worth it. So you'll just lose the territory and then you'll go capture it back. Because that's the way the game works. You have to wait sometimes. You can't go and kill everything with your cool and tech level. Unlike XCOM. So sorry if I have spoken and said too many things in this review, but I can't do this review without mentioning those things, because my score for the game is it's 8 out of 10 with all the mods and all the story and all the games and all the history, everything. It's 8 out of 10. This game could have been a 10 if it had been developed further, meaning additional content, support, graphical design, more. Anyway, let's just leave it at this, because this is a truly a hidden gem, and the modding community has done wonders for it. Okay. This is all I wanted to say about the game for now. Maybe I'll do a let's play on it in the future. But until then, have a nice day, and remember, this game has to be in your collection if you like turn-based games or XCOM. Bye bye.